Hypoxic breathing, what is it and why do it? Ultimately, we are providing less oxygen than normal, than sea level, which is 20.9% approximately, depending upon where you are, oxygen in the air. We're providing less oxygen than that for the body to inhale or inspire. And that is creating or inspiring adaptations, positive adaptations in the body. Now, of course, there could be negative adaptations if you overdo it. And this is why I want you to grab a pulse oximeter when you go through these exercises, because these are very bio-individual and I want to make sure that you are optimizing for you. I've been obsessed with altitude training, hypoxic training, breath work ever since I focused on this area when I was getting my master's in exercise science with a focus in breath work and hypoxic training. Even right now, I'm involved in postgraduate research that's looking at hypoxic breathing protocols in conjunction with exercise, and it's very, very exciting. Firstly, please like, subscribe, share this video as it helps this channel to grow and it allows me to make more quality content like this. Additionally, please visit hypoxix.fitness. This is where you're going to go and take your CO2 tolerance test. In fact, there's a link underneath this video so that you can take that CO2 tolerance test, as we are going to use that score to titrate and optimize and individualize this program for you. Secondly, if you'd like to combine exercise with these breathing protocols, please visit hypoxix.studio. This is where the live and on-demand material combines the technique breathography, which you're gonna learn today, with mobility, core, total body routines. It's really fun, and if you come to class, I will look at you exercising and breathing and give you feedback. There are many benefits to intermittent hypoxic training and intermittent hypoxia exposure. Training means ultimately we're moving and we're exercised in conjunction with that mild hypoxia. Exposure is simply that we're exposing ourselves to lower than normal levels of oxygen while resting, seated, maybe doing some light stretching. I use both of these protocols in my exercise routines. There are many benefits, including cognitive, increased muscle mass, body composition, metabolism. There are so many benefits to performing hypoxic training, but the key is that you optimize it for yourself. My goal for you is to sit between 80 and 90% blood oxygen. I don't really like going much lower than that. If you get in the 70s, it's safe, it's generally fine, but it's kind of like exposing yourself to extreme high intensity exercise. Why not perform the minimum effective dose in order to see those adaptations? Once you've taken your CO2 tolerance test, you know what level you should perform for the hypoxic breathing. This is level one. I want your CO2 tolerance score to be minimum 30 seconds. If it's not at 30 seconds yet, I want you to keep practicing, just slowly breathing, maybe trying that free workout on hypoxix.fitness, because combining that breathing with your workout will improve that CO2 tolerance score faster. Why? Because simply our body is producing carbon dioxide as a byproduct from exercise, and so we're exposing ourselves to higher levels of carbon dioxide within our body, which is a good thing. That increases blood flow to the brain, to the muscles, and also enhances and increases our threshold to be able to tolerate carbon dioxide within the body. I want you to get at least a score of 30 seconds and then come back to this video and perform level one. There is a level two, a level three, more advanced levels of this hypoxic breathing based on your scores for CO2 tolerance. And so over time, measure it once every 4 weeks. When you get to that 40 seconds, 50 seconds, 60 seconds, you can move to those more advanced protocols. That is just a clear marker as to the health of your respiratory system and your ability to tolerate the carbon dioxide. Next, I want you to have a pulse oximeter. I want you to put it on your finger and I want you to watch your blood oxygen drop as we perform these breathing protocols. Now, in this breathing protocol, I want you to exhale to your maximum. We're gonna use something called a forced exhalation. This is forcing all of the air out of the lungs so you move to the end of your breath. So it literally feels like there's no air left in your lungs when you're at the end of that 8 second exhale. That's our starting point. At the end of that 8 second exhalation, we then perform a breath retention, a breath hold. Pausing the breath, our blood oxygen is going to drop more quickly because we have removed all the oxygen from the lungs. We're at the end of the breath. And this has been shown in a plethora of research, including a physiologist who I was very inspired by in even developing this technique, Xavier Warren. So you can look up his research, decades of research, amazing physiologist. Now, let's practice. Exhale for 8 seconds, and then we're gonna perform a breath retention for 15 seconds. Let's go Watch your blood oxygen. We're gonna exhale on a blow today, simply blowing through pursed lips, but I want you to shoot that air out. You're blowing a birthday candle out that is across the room, and I want you to blow that candle out immediately with the force of your air, or like you are a trumpet player and you were trying to blow that highest note possible in eight seconds. So it needs to be pretty darn forceful. Okay, so let's go. Ready? Inhale. Always inhale through the nostrils. And blow. Hold for 15. You can close your eyes. Stay relaxed in your face. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. We're gonna take an inhale right now. Watch that blood oxygen, but tiny inhale through the nose. Involuntary inhale. Let's go again. Exhale 8, 1. Blow it out. Hold for 15. Seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, relax your face, 12, 13, 14, 15, inhale through the nostrils, expanding the ribs, let's go one more time, and then we rest. And one, hold, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and release. Whew. Check your blood oxygen. It generally takes anywhere between 10 and 30 seconds to see your lowest blood oxygen. It just takes a moment for the body to register and for the oxygen carbon dioxide ratio to shift to that breath, that breathing exercise that you just performed. Now I want you to rest for a minimum 60 seconds. That's approximately how much time it takes for the carbon dioxide to recover, the oxygen to recover, and then you're gonna go right back in. I recommend three sets of this tri-set of breathing. This is going to help mimic the intermittent hypoxic exposure protocols that have you in hypoxia for anywhere between 3 and 5 minutes to see those positive adaptations. Now, the interesting uniqueness, love that word, of the breathing protocols is that we are increasing our carbon dioxide as our blood oxygen is lowering, which is a little bit different than breathing hypoxic air. This is where it gets really interesting, because when we increase the carbon dioxide in our body, it also increases the vasodilation of our blood vessels. It increases blood flow to the brain, to the muscles. Really interesting. And this is why I'm so passionate about research in this area, because I find it so fascinating that we can shift these blood gas ratios for potential positive adaptation, mimicking the hypoxic breathing protocols that we see in traditional exercise science, physiology work, putting ourselves in hypoxic chambers, breathing hypoxic air, going to a mountain, doing traditional altitude training. There's variations on within each of these methodologies, within each of these protocols, but there are benefits to hypercapnic training, to increasing those levels of carbon dioxide, and this is why I'm continuing to perform research in this area. And again, please support this channel, like, subscribe, share. It helps me to create these videos and also move more deeply in the research that I'm working on. So please repeat that three times. Repeat it three times over the course of the week. So pick a Monday, a Wednesday, a Friday, repeat these protocols, and then report back to me. Comment under this video and let me know if you've improved your CO2 tolerance score, and also what your measurements are on your pulse oximeter when you go through this breathing protocol. I can help you, and I will always answer the comments here. I can help you individualize the protocol and optimize them for you. Can't wait to see you at the next one. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.